believe that they participate in these crimes. Sometimes I believe that I am sure that their friends, that their investors, that they have supporting them today are part of all the criminal elements on St. Martin. Somebody is going to have to prove me wrong. I see and I hear, I read that Minister Duncan is busy with his civil servants for the last 2 days, telling them who is going to be fired, who is going to be retained. But one of the things that I understood just yesterday and again this afternoon, no one has touched the Social Security SVD. What he has basically said, it's a central issue and we will see about that. These are the people that are representing us in the central government. My fellow, my people, and this is absolutely from my heart. The most important thing to me is the well-being and the health of the St. Martin people. Because I know each and every one of you must now have somebody that have been stricken by cancer, that have been stricken by some illness that is going to basically bankrupt that individual. And tomorrow if we take that service and it is not done properly and we put it in the hands of private insurance companies where these guys think that we can get a piece of the action, every single one of us on this island is doomed to one thing, is what we call the poor man's doctor, which is death. We will all die because we cannot afford the benefits that governments are responsible for in taking care of our people. This is my absolute and my only hope, that every single one of you here this evening that will tell your friends and your families that this is the biggest concern to the Democratic Party. The report coming from every single one of them in this meeting of so-called experts, every single insurance company, they basically told the government that we cannot work for 12.5% premium to cover all the poor people of St. Martin. Something has to be done. Where do you think that money is going to come from? Where are the people that are on minimum wages going to afford more than an 8% that they are contributing right now to the SVD? This is a serious issue and we should not overlook it. They say that we can talk issues. This is the issue I have with them. The next time they come up on stage, tell the people of this island what you are going to do about our Social Security. Where do you plan to send it? Who do you plan to give it to? Let me tell you, my people, believe me, this is the most important issue in this campaign, is to assure that you and your family are properly covered medically. Because yes, we do get sick. We will get sick and we will end up in the hospital one day. This is something that touches each and every one of us. Again, last election, I never in my wildest dream ever imagined that I will be coming here to you, asking you to vote for the Democratic Party in a federal election again. Had they done their job well, we would have gone straight into country status. Because they have sat there for 3.5 years, and what they didn't disrupt for Sarah, they made sure it didn't happen in time. So that is the reason why today we had to have a short circuit election, and then they're saying in 6 or 7 months, we're going to move into another election again. I do not believe, because I know that they feel that they're in comfort zone because they are an island government and they're taking care of all of their friends and then they're taking care of all those investors that have pushed a hell of a lot of money into their campaign. These people must be paid back. And let me tell you, these people are not paid back with nothing else but dollars. Because when they tell you that 12% or 12.5%, when you add up the employer and employee contribution plus the 2.1% of the government, they say, but you know, we can't work for that. We can't work for St. Martin people based on a 12.5%. You simply cannot. They they gotta work for 15% and 20%, and when they do feel it out, when they do give it out to the private friends of theirs, they think that there's going to be some percentage for them. Well, let me tell you something, there's going to be one hell of a lot of scrutiny when it comes to that, because there is no room. This is a government health organized service, and what has been traditionally been the point of departure from all the private companies that ensure people's health benefits is that being basically told, they come together and they say, government, this is what we're going to work for. This is the only thing that we can do to support and to make sure that your people are covered. They collude, they get together, and they tell government, if you don't like this, then we're gone. That means to say that when you and your family and your children and your loved ones are admitted to the hospital and then you are subjected to a second class or third class room, they say, you know something, if these guys want to pay for it, let them find an additional supplementary insurance, because we are going to be basically involved in the poor man's dilemma. When you're sick, you die. And let me tell you again, believe me my words, this shall come to pass if we let these bastards go back into the central government. I remember last year, we came to this very same spot, and they said that we invaded their territory. But let me tell you something, they got their rudest awakening, because we ripped them in every district in St. Peter's, South Ward, and in Saunders. And let me tell you, it will happen again. But this will only happen, my people, with your support, each and every one of you, voting in the same manner you did the last time. And to give us that extra assurance, ask one more person to come with you. And then we go on clear. We have to do nothing different than what we did the last election. Just simply ask one more person to come with you, and I can assure you that the Democratic Party will save us to a safe country that we can all be proud of.